Hey, PushNetPushNet, new little video. This one finally got the project going, and wanted to show you a little pan. Then I'll go back on the window, I'll show you better pictures and stuff. But this is my middle size, my middle system of the Big Brother. So basically, this is where all my radios are. The other two parts, one is more like all the antennas, and then the third part, which I'll do another video a little bit later once I'm getting a few things back, is my battery. So on this side, and this is why I like my system so far, is that it's portable. And the thing is, as you can see now, so right now I'm on the side of my in my office, and I have that on the side of my a corner of my my desk, and so it becomes my home system, but with a few tweaks, because right now I used it yesterday to the net, so this is why I left it that way. But the system, how it works, so all my radios are plugged in there, and I'll show pictures a little bit later on. All the wiring is all done downstairs. So basically all I have to do is plug an antenna, and right now it's in a configuration where I can monitor as well with the Radio Shack. So like yesterday while doing the net, I was listening all the Marin bands, and basically was things. So basically the antenna goes in, this is the antenna for the radio, and then there's another antenna that goes over there. But basically with one antenna I'm monitoring all the frequencies, and the other one is for transmitting as well. On this SAM too, I finally got my signal link. Not working 100%, but at least I'm receiving stuff, so I'm working up a few bugs here and there. And on my labs right now, I got my laptop or my Toughbook, which has all my communication radios on. So basically everything is on. And yesterday I was playing a lot by installing new system and everything, and everything was plug into the system itself through my power supply, and it worked great. I didn't have any bugs, I didn't feel any overheat from the radio or things like that. So in a good 10 hours I spent here, like listening to the radio, having the radio on and everything, because I wanted to see what's the limit of that, and I wanted to see it through the power supplies, because that way I took off the battery out of the equation. And here's how it works a little bit. So basically here, this is to so I got 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I got 6 buttons on there, so 6 switch. The first switch is to get my voltage, my lack of the back of the bar in. So that means that now, right now, if I would want to use my my laptop, it's I bought a connection that it brings 12 volt into, I think that used 19 volts. So basically I got a little amplifier of DC adapter for the Toughbook. So that's great, it works great. Yesterday that's all I did, I had it plugged to the system. The other button is for my radio, and basically how I set it up, and again we'll see some pictures, there's cables that attach all the radios under, and then I did some extension to the front here, so basically all this can be closed nicely, and all this tuck in. Because my radio is made for mobile, so to be in a car, it has like a lot of cables and stuff that can be detached, so that way you can install it at one point in the other side. So that's why it works great for that system as well. So that in my main system here, I got my microphone and my radio, and as you can see now, it got on by that button, close, or I can open it on. Speaker wise, I got different system. So the radio has itself a speaker which I can hear, but I got two extension here, and what I could do, and yesterday I was doing that, I can either bring all the system through the radio. So I got a connection here, and those systems plugs in. And And then you can hear the through the speaker here. You can hear the sound of the radio through the speaker. Or if I want to, or even I can do both because I switch it. I can listen with my portable soda headphones. And those headphones, the reason I bought it and I did a video on that, they have two connections. I don't know if you'll be able to see, but they got two different connections. And I can plug, I think they're for DJs. So they have like two different, whatever music, so that they can switch the other one. And so they plug in on two different things. And they're pretty, because they're for DJs and loud environment, they have a pretty good signal cancellation. Like, it's pretty muffled, the sound right now. And then what I can do is I plug my so I got two little connections here, and basically one goes on each ears, and I was able to listen through the scanner on one ears and my radio on the other here, so I could hear the net as I'm scanning for the Marines and stuff. And so when we do that in the where I am the AOC in during exercise, that's how we do. We have like one repeater on one ear, another repeater on the other here, and so that we can monitor different trips. So basically I can do the same thing with this system. So this is a button here. I got another connection by Anderson Paul for my incoming HF, which will hopefully be a KX2, and I'll be able to connect it straight over here so I can give the power to the KX2. Then I got a Anderson pack. It was an old one Anderson, and you'll be able to see from the bottom. And what I did is I repurposed it, and I did a hole here. So I got three other connection for Anderson, and so I can hook stuff. And then this system over here, it has a clamp, which has a little plastic thing. And what I want to do with this is, it's coming and didn't arrive yet, but it will be, you know, those LED LED kind of rolls of light. And so basically I'll be able to have lights over here. And also don't forget that this is for if power goes down. So that means I don't need to open anything else like my radio or anything, but with this and opening the LED light, which is this system over here, I'll be able to powered lights and have like basically LED lights, all strips of light to illuminate, and they illuminate pretty well. I saw some YouTube videos on that, and basically it'll be able to give the 12 volt, because I bought the 12 volt strip, and so basically the 12 volt will go to that strips and I'll have power. This little extra that I got, and this is why I used this little box, that was a homemade box. It's everything is fused, by the way. And I'll have a picture of that. Everything is fused inside with a marine kind of box that they use like on boats and stuff. So it's a little waterproof, and it's well done. Like the whole battery. So basically the battery pack comes, the power goes to the whole pack, and then it redistributes everything, all fused through the power. So all through the red connections of all the system, and I put the different size of fuse according to what I need and what the device needs and stuff. And so this one here, I'll be using it on the my automatic, and when I do on the next box, basically I got a antenna tuner, and basically the antenna tuner can be plugged on this system and then reconnect and stuff. And then I got one left,